held at Los Angeles, and the Morales world record, of course, is also the American record. We'll take a look now at the field. It's the best ever assembled for this event. In lane number one from Canada's Tom Ponting. In lane two, and watch out for John Sieben of Australia. His coaches told me a moment ago he's going to win. We'll see. Anthony Nesty of the University of Florida and Suriname is a terrific competitor. Then you have Jameson, Biondi, Gross, Yaroshuk of the Soviet Union, and Jay Mortensen of the United States. Anthony Nesty is a very confident young swimmer and a very good one. He's from a little country called Suriname, which is on the north coast of South America. His dad made him become a swimmer because he liked the discipline. He didn't like the sport. Now he's one of the best in the world in the big races. Got to look out for Anthony Nesty. There's Suriname on the north coast, just north of Brazil in South America. Of course, if he wins, he'll be the first guy for even medals. He'll be the first to win a medal in swimming for Suriname.
You know, I anticipate a very fast first 50 out of Matt Biondi, but the interesting thing is after that most recent false start, Matt Biondi was slow to the blocks. Andy Jameson got there right away.
Second start is a good one, and Matt Biondi's out quickly, and they feel it's imperative for him to have a great start, and Biondi swimming in the lead by the slightest of margins. Matt Biondi swimming in lane five, five down from the top. That is Michael Gross now coming up. The man who won gold at Los Angeles. And John Sieben of Australia is indeed going to the wall in good form as they come out of the only turn of the race. 50 meters to swim, and they're faster than a world record split.
Jameson breathing every stroke. Biondi breathing every two. He's got plenty of smooth water. Can he hold on?
It is Matt Biondi in the lead. Biondi seems to have put away Gross. We'll see if Gross can come back. They now have 15 meters to swim. They now have 10 meters to swim. Matt Biondi going for the goal. John Sieben coming hard on the outside. But Biondi looks like he's going to take it to the wall. And they get Nesty finally takes it in lane three at the very last moment. Matt Biondi finished second. Apparently Biondi's stretch wasn't quite there. And Nesty, that powerful little swimmer from Suriname, found a way, and he beat out Biondi in the very last stroke of this race. A major upset.
It was all in the finish, Don. Absolutely. No question about it. Biondi's got a plenty of the lead. Nesty's right here. You see him in lane three from the top. Biondi had the lead. He chose to take a long, easy glide to the finish. He probably should have taken four shorter strokes instead of three long ones. One, he's 10 meters away from the finish now, and he's got plenty of a lead. Keep your eye at this guy all the way to the wall, Nesty. Biondi's going to take two more strokes, and he coasts from here on in. He coasted 3 meters. Look at that glide. Nesty at the top said, no, I'm going to go. It's a sprint to the finish. Biondi deserves the loss because he could have won that race. He could have won that race. He should have swung head up, looked for the wall, five strokes down, and paced it correctly. He decided to glide with the dolphin kick.
There's Anthony Nesty.
That's American Dara Torres giving him a hug.
Yeah, they go to the University of Florida together. Anthony Nesty's a terrific kid. I had a chance to spend a lot of time with him. He's very confident. And he put Suriname on the map. Not that it's not already there, but it certainly hasn't been in swimming. As you see, Biondi finished second as Nesty got him with an Olympic record time. Jameson, the fastest qualifier from Great Britain, finished third. John Sieben, the Aussie, was fourth. And Michael Gross, who won at Los Angeles, did no better than fifth. We'll be back with more on the men's 100-meter butterfly in a moment.
Spirit of the Olympics, brought to you by MCI.
This is Don Crickey with John Neighbor back in Olympic swimming. Well, we've just had an upset in the men's 100-meter butterfly. Anthony Nesty from the little nation of Suriname on the north coast of South America, a swimmer also for the University of Florida, is Anthony. He touched out, and you'll see him in three down from the top of the screen. That's Anthony Nesty. Matt Biondi, the United States, is leading as they go to the wall. And apparently feels he has it won. He strokes easily and stretches out. Does not take the other stroke. And Nesty, with that powerful stroke, gets into the wall first and just edges out Matt Biondi for the gold. And there is Suriname, which now has its first Olympic gold medal winner. And we're going to meet him along with Matt Biondi as we go down to John.
Thanks, Don. Congratulations, Anthony. Any special significance that this is the first medal for your country?
Well, I'm very happy to be in here and win the first medal and all. And I'm just excited right now. Can't believe it.
Did you have any idea you were that close to the lead?
Well, I knew I was out pretty slow. I mean, not slow, but I knew I was out maybe fourth or fifth place out of 50. And I tried. All I could do is bring it home, and I did.
Well, congratulations. Best of luck. Rest of the meet.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Unfortunately, Matt Biondi was here to give us a few comments, was pulled away to do the award ceremony, so we'll perhaps get a comment from him later. Don?
Okay, John, so we have Anthony Nesty, winner of gold in the men's 100-meter butterfly. Biondi, who seemed to have it won, losing in the final moments, and the third finisher, Andy Jamieson. Now from Olympic Park Swimming Pool, it's back to Bryant Gumbel. Bryant? Thank you, Bryant. We're ready for the medal ceremony as the three top finishers in the men's 100-meter butterfly come out, led by Anthony Nesty of Suriname. That is Matt Biondi of the United States, who seemingly had the race won and kind of cruised to the wall when Nesty overpowered with that last stroke. So Matt Biondi now has bronze and silver, winning silver in this event. The third finisher was Andy Jamieson.
It was a thrilling race all the way to the finish. Biondi all ahead. He's got about a meter, 3 feet on Nesty. Nesty's right here from Suriname. Nesty never stops. He just keeps turning out that rapid turnover between them. Andy Jamieson, he breathes every stroke and he's looking very long. But from this point in, Biondi coasts. Nesty just keeps on coming a little bit faster and hits the wall first. Mikkel Gross.